So hello friends. So this video is answer to one of the question which was asked in one of my YouTube video comments. So one of my friend was trying to solve this trust problem, and whenever he was trying to use the link elements and solve it, he was getting some error and was not able to get the answers. But whenever he was using the beam elements, he was getting the results. So before we resolve this problem, let's see what kind of system he has, what kind of mesh forces are there. So first let's look into the geometry. So they are the beam element. You can see model type is beam here. Okay, that's no problem. Let's go ahead with beam first. Mesh. Okay, so if you see the mesh, there are multiple nodes in between the lines, which means that each truss member or each these line elements are divided into multiple parts. So when you convert in link element, this will not work, because to work with link element you need to have only one element per link member. Okay, so if you have multiple element, you'll have multiple degree of freedom in between, and they are free to rotate on all these nodes, and because of not having proper fixity, the model may not converge. Okay, so to do that, to resolve that, let's try to remesh it such that each line member has one element. So we'll give pretty big element size. You can see that this scale is 0.7 meter. So I guess all these line parts are in the range of 1 meter, so I'll give the size 10 meter. Okay, and create the mesh again. Now you can see that here now we have one element on each line member. Okay, so that's done. Now next step, let's understand the forces in boundary condition. So the force is applied here radially downward. This particular location has simply supported. It means all 3 degrees of freedom are restrained. At this point it is a displacement 000, so very similar to the simply supported. That's fine. Displacement 2. So in this case you can see that the deflection in the x direction is restrained. It means that this point cannot move in the x direction, but it is free to move in the y direction or vertically, and in the z direction or normal to this plane, it is free, it is restrained. Okay, so that's fine. Now fixed rotation. Okay, so the link element, by definition, they are free to rotate at each joint. So I think we should not use these things, as well as the link elements does not have rotational degree of freedom. So even if you apply, they may not work if you use the link element. So let's delete this. Now solve it. Wait for few seconds. Okay, some message is coming, but we can see that total deformation, we can plot it and it is coming fine. But one thing to remember that we are still solving it as a beam element and it is working fine. So let's convert it in link elements. So I'll just go here and change from beam to link and truss. Once you do that, you have to again update the mesh. It's updated. Let's solve it again. Yeah, it is solved with no issue. You can see same deformation, similar deformation you can see here. Let's insert the axial force and check. Okay, we'll not be able to plot axial force before resolving it, solving it again. Yeah, so this is the axial force on each member. You can see these two members are shown in blue. They are subjected to compressive load, and the red color is subjected to maximum tensile load. And that is what we expect, right? When you apply a radial downward load here or vertical downward load here, you expect this beam to subject to tensile stress or tensile load, and these two compressive. So I think our model is working fine, and I hope my friend got the answer what he was looking for. And thanks for watching. Have a good day.